It's been here, aka Mr. Same Old BS, and you are now watching the Circle NYC After Show. And our guest today is man-made. We have Tam and Miss Terry. How you doing?
I'm fabulous. How are you?
You was looking at me waiting to mess up your name, wasn't you?
I thought you was waiting for me to mess it up. I'm a boss of many names, so I just knew you was gonna fuck it up, but you got it right today.
First of all, your makeup. Let's get into that. This color scheme, is that red on your eyebrows too?
It's a mix of many things.
I like it.
Yeah, we love the crayon box. Like, I'm one of those girls. Like,
oh, okay.
Even though I'm a trans woman, I still love drag. So I'm bound to put on anything and do it all.
Did you do drag before a trans?
Yeah, I did drag for what we both did. We both started with drag. We were both cross-dressers.
Yeah, you know, put on a little show, get a little tip, and then you became full-time back in our day.
Okay.
And after full-time, it became training, and then became trans and transgender, so you know how that goes.
So many terms.
Yeah, you know I'm real old.
It's evolved.
Now, let's talk about, like, some fun stuff. Let's talk about The Circle, right? What do you guys think about The Circle Season 3 so far?
It's my favorite season.
Is it?
Yeah, I've been watching.
Is it because Bugs is on there? Of course it's because Bugs is on
well,
there.
Well, okay. And this particular season is my favorite because it focuses on music, and that's one of my passions.
Awesome.
But Bugs is nice.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of Bugs and music, you have a song with Bugs that we got to see you perform on The Circle. It's your favorite season so far, so you must be really into it with this whole Melly, because you recognize Melly, you know Melly's character from season 2. So
I'm not familiar.
Oh.
Girl. I'm not familiar. Do you know?
I'm not familiar with this Melly on this season.
Okay. What's the difference?
I know Melly from the season. I met him on season 2. He's actually been a part of our show, Living Man Made. He was a close, I guess a good Judy, but she's showing me different. Like, the things that she talks about, when everybody thinks that she's talking about them, I think she's talking about herself. She's the fake one. She's the one who pops out for the camera. She's talking about herself and everybody getting offended because she makes it look like she's talking about you. But she's very selfish and she's talking about herself all the time. Mm. Even when she's selling that, she's talking about herself.
That was a read.
No, it's the truth. Oof. When she's talking about people that's not bosses, you're the one who's doing shows with your friends. Everybody else on the show are doing jobs. You're talking about yourself.
Oh, shit.
I watch it. I love the show.
That's one of the more interesting concepts about it.
Don't even get offended by her. She's talking about herself.
Okay. That's a very interesting concept about the situation that we've noticed is she has so many jobs, but we never get to see her working. I'm like, well, girl. But anyway.
And that's not being shady because, you know, we trans women. You know, you don't see a lot of us working, but we are.
I'm sorry, I got a real loud laugh. Y'all, that's good.
I'm just playing this good. Way. You know, that was a good Judy.
This is good TV.
It was a good Judy. I don't like the Melly on season 3. I might like season 4 Melly if she come back. I love season 2 Melly. Mm. Don't like season 3 Melly.
Gotcha. And I remember Melly was saying that he got you guys work or something like that.
I believe that we have done some things together with some of the people that are working for her or pay her for things, that we gave them jobs. And she's then speaking against me at one of our events, but I've never been to none of her events.
Oh, so you booked her?
Yeah, twice.
Let's be clear.
Twice.
No, several times. Well, no, I won't do that. We booked her once, and we booked a lot of her clients. She have good clients or good social friends.
Okay.
But herself, what's she do?
So, I mean, like, some people could say it's a connection. For you to bring someone to my door that I have to write a check for, maybe that's a connection. In some people's mind, maybe it's not. In my opinion, that was not a connection. That was you bringing a bitch to my door that I had to write a check for. So, I mean, like, when you start bringing bitches to my door that's for free, we'll talk about that. But as long as I gotta sign a check, I don't see what it is.
Okay.
So, okay. But in all point and purpose, I let people live how they wanna live, make up whatever delusions they would like to make up, say whatever needs to say that makes them better, because I'm a boss. And a boss don't turn to dress every bitch that's talking shit.
Do you guys ever feel like the situation with Melly can be resolved?
No.
Never?
Never. I didn't know that he was that person.
Understood.
Until he went after Michelle Fontaine, and am I saying it right?
Michelle LaFontaine.
And he said very disturbing things about her being a trans woman that I find confusing. And if you were my friend who had dinner at my table, my black trans table, you would not say that. And if you would, you can't be my friend. Because we don't live under that nature.
Understood.
I don't care what she wears. I don't care when she wears it. If she's transitioning to a woman, respect it. Because if you don't know what it's like, you don't know what she's going through, back up. Give that woman her space. It's not for me. It's not my decision. It's not his either. Or anybody else to come in and say what she's supposed to have on that makes her a woman.
Yes.
Transitioning into a woman is not about the clothes you wear. Bitch, you could be dressed in everything feminine from head to toe and be a man.
Yes.
It does not matter. If Michelle says she's a woman, she's a woman.
Okay.
Back up.
All right.
I'm dating. Everybody, I'm dating. I'm getting out there. I'm putting myself out there.
Every Sunday is like a religion for us at Man-Made. We get together, we eat, we fellowship, we laugh, we kiki, we pit.
Cause she talked to Genuine Beauty too.
Bitch, I don't talk no goddamn Genuine Beauty. Stop doing that.
Y'all went on a date?
Bitch, stop.
What y'all went on a date?
It was a blind date.
Oh yeah, I didn't know. They went on a date.
I'm a crybaby, y'all. I'm real emotional.
What's wrong with trans on trans love?
Nothing, they all need love.
So why you don't want to love
Fuck you!
Before I met you, I got to see Living Man-Made.
Okay.
And that's the appropriate name of the show that you can find on the YBN channel here on YouTube. Yes, you can. I love the name Man-Made because there's nothing like it anywhere.
It was different for me because they'll tell you I'm not into being in the front round. I'm like being I'm the background kind of girl.
Mm-hmm.
So it was different to see different the way that people saw us and actually putting out our truth. And then, you know, there's different forms and aspects of trans and just you can believe in yourself. And he actually took a chance and let us show the world what we are actually doing. You see, you hear about the different communities and what they're doing in the community organizations, but you don't actually know what they go through.
We would love to continue filming the show, but it would need more financial support.
Okay.
It's not cheap.
Well, and Nunu do a great job and he's not cheap.
Well, in my opinion, I feel like you guys should continue to do it because it is something original and it's something that's great and it's something that's nowhere, like, anywhere else.
One of our biggest missions is to bring visibility to the trans community, specifically POC, people of color, within the trans community, because often they are the most overlooked. And their frustrations and their oppressions are mostly pushed to the side and not seen in everyday life. So we like to bring visibility to those energies and those efforts.
Thank you guys so much
for being here and talking with me.
You guys are like another breath of fresh air.
Oh,
amazing.
You can find Man-Made Productions on Instagram_Man-Made Productions and on Facebook/Man-Made Productions.
Or you can find me at Tamara Man-Made on Instagram, Facebook, all the good stuff. Or you can go to Buzz Gutter. He normally posts something every 5 minutes. So just go to Buzz Gutter. Like, that's what he does.
Okay. Thank you for watching us today. I'm your host, Bennett, aka Mr. Same Old BS, and this is the Circle NYC After Show. We hope to catch you next week.
Bye.